So, as you guys probably know by now, I finished Hogfather, and so now I'm going to be watching the movie. If you would like to watch the movie, I promise to talk through it and be that annoying person who we all secretly want to watch movies with. This is okay for me to do because you can't see, but I'm alone in the comfort of my home and like cuddled up in bed. Which is how I suggest we watch all movies. So here we go. I have The Hogfather Season 1, Episode 1. I'm streaming off of Amazon, and I am clicking play. It's a skull! It's a secret skull! Explosions. This is such dramatic music for like a ridiculous scene. He's a turtle with elephants on his back. Like, it's hard to take this music seriously right now. Susan is one of my favorite Discworld characters. Just because she's so fed up with all of Discworld. For some reason, I don't really like this casting of Lord Downey, and I don't really like this casting of Tea Time or Tea Time. I don't know why. I mean, they're not bad castings, they're just not how I envision them in my head. I mean, the entire Guild of Assassins is not really how I pictured it. And take off those John Lennon glasses. I just imagine Downey being much like middle age younger almost. I don't know. And I hate this voice of the auditors. It's impressive how much of the script is snagged like directly from the book. I do like that about this adaptation. If you are a UK watcher, sherry is not like a huge drink here. I think it would, like, the people would think that that was red wine. They wouldn't think it was sherry, I think. I don't know. Let me know if that's different for you guys. If you're wondering what that is, that's a train. They happen a lot where I live. Oh, that's a fed up face, Lord Downey. I wish they had done these with Muppets instead of with like CGI stuff. I'm partial to Muppets though. I'd also really like to see a Henson version of this, actually. Like something by Toby Fround or something. Maybe we can get Mary Robinette Kowal on that. She does puppets. I love this guy. Very psychological. There's something super creepy about this guy's voice. There's a movie, it's called Nightcrawler with what's his face, Jake Gyllenhaal, and I always think that approach is like there's something very intentionally like trying to be creepy about tea time in this movie, whereas there's something not intentionally creepy, like there's much more of an innocent sociopath kind of vibe in Nightcrawler, if that makes sense, and I think that would be more fitting, but oh well. Very psychological. Because you don't have eyes, really. Alternatively, go and join the Night's Watch. Oh, Banjo. I just want to sit him down and feed him or something. I don't know. Oh my God, Twilla, go to sleep. Like, your brother is sleeping through this. You can do it too. He's like half your age. I do like that effect that they do on her face. Mother, whoa, bad words at you. Poor Banjo. Ah, oh, that's the most grating. That is the most grating fake laugh thing. Blech. That's a wig. That's a wig if there ever was one. I've almost cast a kid in Tea Time's role. I don't know. The entirety of Unseen University just makes me laugh so hard. Look at this 30s. Oh man. Well, it's a good use of dollar store glitter. It's funny because it's like they spent money on all of the things that I would not spend money on. Like, I would have gotten a better skeleton, I guess. Instead of spending all the money on the CGI of the great Atuan. It sounds like he's got like plastic in his hand every time he moves. Think part of the hard part about these movie adaptations, especially for something like Discworld, is that like there's a lot of really whimsical world building that you just can't get the same out of, or it must just be really hard to adapt to screen because it's not very commonly done. Oh, this is perfect. This is how I imagine the Tooth Fairy's castle would be. And that's definitely, they just put the wig in that rug. There's not a person. B for effort, guys. I just wish some of the world building had been a little bit more elegantly transferred. coworker is being attacked and just hides. Jeez, Albert, just like put that breakfast on a plate or something. Lazy bones. That's interesting. It's not even just a wig. It's like an orphan Annie wig. I'm sorry, I just can't get over it. Why would you do audio correction on like the dwarf? That's weird. Well, now you just made a mess. I wish Santa Claus had pigs instead of reindeer. Some of this storytelling really loses out in that you can't build the mystery of what's happening as well. And they're trying to do a lot of explanation as they go along, which just doesn't exist in the book. I don't know. No, little mouse. The score in this is pretty good, though. I really like it. I don't know why they included this shower stuff.
Just like this is the most random. This is the big-lipped alligator stuff of this movie. I do always wonder how much Tim Burton just rewatched and watched and rewatched The Hogfather. They're not even moving at all with that hill behind them. Oh, Susan. That's gonna be some serious indigestion. I wish we'd seen Susan use the voice already. Like, there was that one time, but. Oh, Susan, she has the best hair. Is spelling pun PUNE like a weird British spelling? I don't know. If you pay attention, you can answer that. This is one of my favorite parts of the entire book.
That's clever. I should do that. Just a bottle of wine tucked away where it looks like it's all bath salt. That is my reaction as well, Albert, when someone tells me I can't want something because I'm a girl.
Well, this is cool.
I like this representation of this, like, going back in time. That's cool. Cry, baby, cry. Make your mama sigh. Why'd they give this guy that much teeth? Seems really unnecessary. Oh, Banjo.
I didn't even know people could roll their own cigarettes until I was an adult, like 23, 22, or something like that. It does kind of miss the corporate nature of the Tooth Fairy in Discworld.
now in the world of things that didn't happen in the book. That's weird. Don't say it like that. Does he look like the Hogfather, Susan? Don't ask dumb questions. Oh, and thus ends part one. I will almost certainly be watching part two later, and I will clue you guys in on what I'm thinking then, too.